Good morning, all of you. In the last class, we studied a new topic that was phones, right? And we discussed about that come under the category of homophones. So, can you tell me what are homophones?
Homophones are. Words are the same.
Just a moment, please. Hold on. I would like to get the answer from single students. Yes, Felix.
Homophones are words that have same sound and different meanings and different spellings.
Spellings. Okay. Ryan, do you agree with our Felix, what he said?
Yes.
What homophones?
Homophones are same pronouncing words.
Same words with different?
Different words.
Different. They are entirely different words, but they are pronounced exactly the same way. Okay. And today we are going to do two exercises based on homophones. So please take your workbook, page number 84.
Ma'am, I join now.
84?
84, yes. Page number
84. 84.
Okay,
ma'am. I took it.
84.
Okay.
And page number?
84. Fill in the blanks with the correct homophones from the options given in brackets. Okay. Page number 84 of your workbook. Workbook. I had asked you to keep ready both your workbook and textbook. So after doing the exercise in the workbook, we will start with the continue with
chapter.
The text. Not new chapter exactly. We have to do the reading comprehension. Okay. Yes. So Kirtana, read the first sentence.
The baby was dashed, so he started crying.
Okay.
Bored.
Okay. Because both the words, we have got two board there. You have to tell me which is the spelling, correct board.
B-O-R-E-D.
Exactly. So please write B-O-R-E-D, board. What do you mean by board? Lacking interest. Yes. Lack interest. Board lacks interest. And whereas board, the other word given there, it's a long flat piece of wood. You need not write down this, you just fill in the blanks. A long flat piece of wood is the other board, white board, black board, etc. Please write along with me, okay? Now, Jenica. Jenica, unmute your audio. Jenica, you need not write when you are traveling. It will strain your eyes, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
You can just put a tick mark. Tick mark on the right option, and after reaching home, you can write it. Don't write now. Yes,
what's the answer? First one,
Jenica. Second one,
because of the network.
Would you like me to call in level?
Just a moment, I was not able to hear. The question was to Jenica. Yes, Jenica, unmute your audio.
Would you like me to call him as well. H-I-M.
Yes, H-I-M. Him. What do you mean by the other him? H-Y-M-N. Does anyone know what is other him? The other him means the mantras. Okay, when you go to temples, when you do pujas, they will chant mantras. Huh? In Hindu religion. So that is called hymns. Okay. Now, the third one, Manas, read the third one.
It has dash a long time since we last met. First bean.
First bean, very good. B E E N. The other one is a vegetable, right? B E A N is vegetable. But look at the words, both are pronounced exactly the same way. I'm sorry. Okay. Now, fourth one. Parvati. Parvati's video is not seen. I hardly get to ask questions to Parvati. Yes, please unmute your audio. Can you hear me? Unmute. It's taking a lot of time. Maybe network problem. Mayuk. Mayuk, unmute your audio.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read the fourth one.
I did not dash the bell. Second here.
Yes, H E A R. I did not hear the bell ring. I did not hear the bell ring. Krishna. Fifth one.
Orange dash is very useful in making medicines. Second.
Second. See what I have written below that?
No, first.
P-E-E-L. P-E-E-L is the outer covering. The outer covering of a fruit. And peel is the correct answer. P-E-E-L. And look at the other peel. P-E-A-L. A loud ringing of bell is called peel. He burst into peals of laughter. You might have come across such a usage when you read storybooks. After hearing the joke, he burst out into peals of laughter. So that peal means a loud ringing of bell, that bell-like sound. Okay, that is the meaning of the word P-E-A-L, whereas P-E-E-L is the outer covering. Okay, now, Joanne. Sixth one. Yes, read sixth one.
My sister
dash. Unmute. Janvi.
My sister's dash hot samosas near the beach on Sundays. S-E-L-L.
Exactly. S-E-L-L. Sell. So look at the meaning. Sell is give in exchange for money, whereas C-E-L-L is a small room. Cell is another word used for the word prison. And of course, we also call the mobile phone as cell phone. That is also C-E-L-L. Okay, so here we have to use S-E-L-L. Hot samosas near the beach on Sundays. Now let's move on to the next set of exercise. Srihari.
Ma'am?
Yes, read.
The dash played lovely music at the wedding. Band.
Which band?
B-A-N-D. First one.
first one, band. The other band means restrict something, by officially restrict something, that is the second band. Okay, smoking is banned in this place, prohibited. Okay, now
excuse me,
Sarah, second one. Unmute. You are muted.
The dash was not allowed to cast its vote as he was not 18 years old.
Allowed to cast his vote as he was not 18 years old yet. Yes, so which minor will you use there?
M-I-N-O-R.
Yes, exactly. M-I-N-O-R, minor. The other one is who works or who is involved in the mining work, right? Oil mining, metal mining, all those. So that job is called mining, and a person who is involved in is called minor. Whereas a person who is below or under the age of 18 is called a minor, and that is M-I-N-O-R. Okay. Minor. Manav, third one.
Ayan liked Dash chocolate. S-W-E-E-T.
Obviously, it is S-W-E-E-T. Manav, can you tell me what is the other sweet?
Ma'am, other sweet means when you go to a hotel and when it's very special.
Okay, sweet rooms, right?
Yes.
Normally, you might read it as suit. It is not suit. It is like pronounced as sweet, right? Suite of rooms. And it is also used as a collective noun for rooms. Yes. You remember it? I had taught you. Suite of rooms. Yes.
Ma'am. I have a doubt in the third question, ma'am.
Third question. Yes. Which one? Which one?
Bean.
Okay. Yes. It has been.
Ma'am. It's written, it has been a long time since we last met.
Okay.
But bean, we say, I had beans yesterday. So it's not same pronunciation.
I had?
Beans.
Okay. See, this is a singular form, beans.
Yes, ma'am, it's not the same pronunciation.
No, it's not. See, here S is not there, my dear. S is not there. Even Mr. Bean, it is me, B-E-A-N, right? Mr. Bean, B-E-A-N. It is just that we have used the singular form of bean. Bean. You might be thinking of this being B-E-I-N-G. Is this a bean you are saying about? Anyway, these two beans are the same pronunciation, Manav. It has been a long time since we last met. I actually did not clearly understand what is your confusion. If still your confusion is not clarified, please call me in the evening. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay then, the next one. Aditi. Fourth one.
I can count the dash of the beak.
Wait, fourth one
on
now.
On my fingers.
Fourth one. Rishi Dash.
Rishi Dash is motorbike to the factory. First one.
Yes, first road. And can you tell me this first road is the past tense of which word?
Ride.
Ride, exactly. It is the past tense form of the word ride. So you might get confused with this homophones because motorbike is written. And you will try to associate that particular word with the R-O-A-D. But here you have to check the sentence. You have to understand the sentence. We have to use the verb here. And here we are using the verb form of ride. Rishi rode his motorbike to the factory. Yes. Now the next one. Niranjan. Fifth one.
I can count the dash of the week on my fingers. Days. Second one.
Yes, second. And what do you mean by the first days? Days. Something like shining, glittering. Okay. Now, Kirtana, the last one.
This one.
Last sentence.
I gave my mother a beautiful dash on Mother's Day. Rose. R-O-S-E.
Yes. R-O-S-E. And you all know what you mean by R-O-W-S. Rows and columns. It's different. Okay. So here you have to be very careful with the spelling when you fill up the blank. Looking at the sentence and try understand what is given. And you have to fill in the word in such a way that the sentence make complete sense. Okay. So that's all with the workbook exercises for today. Now you can close the book and take your textbook, open it and get ready with page number 65. This is what we have on page number 65, right? Reading comprehension, R6.
Speech keeps our mouth.
65.
Speech keeps our mouths moist.
Has anyone heard about the animal called llama? Has anyone heard about llama? Yes, Isha. Tell me, what do you know about llama?
Llamas are a type of type that like lives in the mountain areas and all.
Okay.
It has so much hair on its back.
Okay.
So it keeps it warm.
Okay. It's a hairy animal, right? Yes. Okay. Then anybody else? Yes, Janvi. What do you know about llamas?
It is found in Peru.
Peru, yes. Somewhere in South America, right? Peru, Chile, Argentina. These are the places where llamas are found. And what has Felix to say about it? Felix? Yes, Felix. What do you know? Sorry, please unmute. What do you know about llamas?
Llamas have a special features about spitting. That means if you keep them annoying or if you try to take a photo of it will get annoyed and try to spit. And it has bad smell.
Okay, fine. And what about Aditi?
Ma'am, I was also going to say that.
Same thing. Okay, fine. Okay, so just a moment. I would like to show you a video. Just watch it carefully, okay? Can you see it, children? Yes? Okay.
Ma'am, I can also.
This is a llama.
Okay. It's breaking.
It resembles a camel.
Some food maybe. Oh.
I hope you saw that. Did you see what happened at the end?
Breaking.
Okay, maybe yeah. A problem.
It was
It literally spat on the face of the lady at the end, right? So this is a special feature about llama. And what is Janvi showing? Okay, what is that, Janvi? Sorry, please unmute.
Llama.
Llama. Just a moment. Yes.
I think it's a toy, llama.
Is it a toy? Like, I'm not able to see that, what do you say, shape properly. Okay, it's a toy llama. Okay. Like, with thick fur.
Ma'am, can I say one more feature about llamas?
Yes.
They spit because they, if they find the food of llamas, and some animals also will come to eat it, right? So if they take it, llamas will get annoyed of that. So they will spit to keep them free away.
Okay.
If a tiger came to attack them or lion came to attack them, so llamas try to spit on their face or their body. The bad smell of the llama change the what you'll say, animal's mind. So it will go away.
Okay, fine. Okay, anyway, happy to know that you have a lot of information about llama, but when I read this passage, it was the first time I'm hearing about it. Okay, anyway, it's like you all might be curious to know about this llama. So let's read the passage and then we have to answer the questions. Okay, spit keeps our mouths moist and softens our food when we chew. Without spit in our mouths, we would have a hard time talking and swallowing. But for some animals, spit works better after it has left the mouth. Some animals are experts at surviving because they are expert spitters. Llamas are animals that like their personal space. A llama that feels threatened or annoyed will split slimy gobs at you to get you to leave it alone. Sometimes llamas even spit on each other to steal food. Llama's spit includes food from the llama's stomach and it can be quite smelly. When a llama spits on another animal, the animal usually loses its appetite and walks away, leaving its food behind. The archer fish is a very skilled spitter. Okay, let's read about llama again. So what the first paragraph says about the importance of spit. It's also called saliva, right? Saliva. What is the advantage? What is the benefit of saliva in the mouth? It keeps our mouth moist. What do you mean by the word moist? What do you mean by moist, children? Moist? Who can say? Moist? Yes, Srihari?
Ma'am, moist means soft.
Or wet, right? Wet.
Soft or wet.
Yes, soft and wet. And softens our food when we chew. You know how the food gets mixed with the saliva and starts the first step of digestion. You might have studied this thoroughly in your science, right? In the digestive system. And without spit in our mouths, we could have had a hard time. Even talking will be impossible without saliva in the mouth. And even swallowing of the food. But for some animals, spit works better after it has left the mouth. For us, the spit plays its role when it is inside the mouth, right? But for some animals, it helps them better or it benefits them better when it leaves the mouth. Some animals are experts at surviving because they are expert spitters. And the animals that spit their saliva out are called spitters, and there are some expert spitters. Llamas are animals that like their personal space. They like privacy. Okay, a llama that feels threatened or annoyed, as Felix said, if somebody annoys this animal, or when the animal feels that it is in danger. Threatened means when they feel that they are in danger, they will spit slimy gobs at you to get you leave it alone. So what are slimy gobs? You know, how many of you play with slime? That plaything, it's very sticky, right? You can make any shape out of it, and it's very cold, very soft, very smooth. So their spit comes out like slimy. For example, you can see a trail of slimy substance when a snail crawls, right? Have you ever touched the area where a snail has crawled? Has anyone done that? It's very yucky actually. Yes, Izan was reluctant to raise his hand, but he has tried it. Izan, how was the feel?
Ma'am, it was very slimy.
Yes, slimy, sticky, and you feel like yucky, right? But you play, you enjoy playing with that slime. That is very nice actually. It's very cold. Ma'am. Yes, it's very good. Very interesting. Okay, so here what happens, the llama spits out slimy gobs at you to get you to leave it, so that you will literally leave it alone. Sometimes llamas even spit on each other to steal food. How is it done? Llama spit includes food from the llama's stomach, and it can be quite smelly. It will have a bad smell. When a llama spits on another animal, the animal usually loses his appetite. He will not feel like eating his food again. What do you mean by appetite? Appetite means the desire for food, the hunger. Okay, suppose when an animal is eating its food, he's enjoying its food, llama will come and spit on it. And that slimy gobs will be so smelly that this animal will leave the food and go. And then the llama will have its share. Okay, when a llama spits on another animal, the animal usually loses its appetite and walks away, leaving its food behind. Now, there are two more animals which have the same sort of speciality. One is the archer fish is a very skilled spitter. It takes aim and spits jet of water at insects and other small creatures to knock them into the water. Then it gulps them down quickly. I'll show you. See, this is another animal. Okay, I'll show that later. Is it the same thing? Yes, let it be here. I'll show you the next one also. Yes. Can you see the screen, children? Yes. Okay. So here, the first, apart from llama, we have another type of creature, that is archer fish. Okay, see, look at the archer fish. The archer fish is a very skilled spitter. It takes aim and spits jet of water at insects and other small creatures to knock them into the water. Then it gulps them down quickly. Look at the insect that is on the leaf. Archer fish will spurt out or spit out jet of water on that insect, and the insect will be falling into the water, after which the archer fish will gulp them down. So this is one of an expert spitter. And look at the other one. Spitting cobras are also known for their expert aim. These snakes spray venom from their fangs. See, look at that. That is not water. They are spraying the venom. What is that venom? Venom is a poison. Venom is the poison that is like stored in their fangs. I hope you know what are fangs. Fangs are that sharp pointed teeth on two sides of the cobra's mouth. These snakes spray venom from their fangs to protect themselves. Scientists believe that these snakes actually aim for the eyes. When the cobra's venom gets into the eyes of an animal, the venom causes terrible pain and even blindness. This gives the snake plenty of time to get away. So look at both the pictures. Archer fish is an expert spitter and he spits out water in such a force that the insects fall into the water and they can prey on it. Whereas the cobras are expert spitters and they spit venom from their fangs to escape from the enemies. And this venom is targeted at the eyes of the other person, maybe the animal or even human beings. Once you get to the eyes, you might become blind. And this will be the opportunity for the cobras to escape from the spot. Okay, so this is about the passage. So what you have to do is, you have to read the passage once again, very carefully. I hope the passage is clear to you, right? Riza, can you read the passage from the beginning once again? We have just 3 more minutes. We'll just read and try to answer it by yourself. Find out the answers and we'll discuss in the next class.
Spit keeps our mouths moist and softens our food when we chew. Without spit in our mouths, we would have a hard time talking and swallowing.
Okay, sorry. But enough. Siddhi, continue. Yes, Siddhi. Izan, continue. Can't unmute? Can't do it. Why?
Why do you unmute me?
I don't know. Selin, can you unmute?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. But for some animals, spit works better after it has left the mouth. Some animals are experts at surviving because they are expert spitters. Llamas are animals that like their personal space. A llama that feels threatened or annoyed will spit slimy
gobs
at you to get you to leave it alone.
Okay, enough. Maria, continue. Enough selling. Good.
Sometimes llamas even spit on each other to steal food. Llama spit includes food from the llama's stomach and it can be quite smelly. When a llama spits on another animal, the animal usually loses its
appetite
and walks away, leaving its food behind. The archer fish is a very skilled spitter. It takes aim and spits jets of water at insects and other small
creatures
to knock them into the water. Then it gulps them
down quickly. Okay, children, that's all. It's time for us to wind up the class. Just go through the passage once again and try to find out the answers of this. Okay. It will be a homework for you and next class we'll discuss the answers. And please make sure that you complete the exercise from the workbook also. So that's all for today. Thank you all. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.